out there that wish you were me, get in line, baby, because I am. I am. The Baby Maker.
What's this? This is the Gorgeous Jared Show, and it's the 20th anniversary year. So I hope you all enjoy today's tonight's premiere of the 20th season. Now, my name is Kay Lazar. I've been reading the internet lately, and there's all this stuff about me not being on this show, and I believe everything I read on the internet. So I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm really here, or if it's a rerun, but. But I was told I should come here, and here I am. And so we're going to enjoy ourselves tonight with the Gorgeous George Show. I tell you, it's been we're going to talk about so many things. Wait till you see George. He is at the top of his form. We're going to talk about. There's so much in politics going on. There's so much changing. This has probably been the year where more things have changed, like it or not. And this is how things go. Things move forward. Things you thought were shoo-ins last year, like a congressman, straight marriage, out of Iraq. All that stuff is back. everything old is new again. I've had quite a time. I was on a plane recently. And the stewardess came and asked me if I wanted a drink. And I said, yeah, I'll have a scotch and soda. And she asked the Catholic priest next to me, he said, would you like a drink too? And the priest says, no, I don't want a drink. I'd rather make love to a woman than have a drink. And so I told the stewardess, hold my drink. I didn't know we had a choice. I remember a nun. I have a whole bunch of religious jokes now. I remember a nun giving an abstinence lecture once. She told all these kids, you know, not to have sex, and these are the wages of sin. There's death, and you know the usual thing you probably got when you were a teenager. Well, the nun said to all the girls in this classroom, she said they were about eighth graders. She said, an hour of fun is not worth a lifetime of misery. Are there any questions? And one girl raised up her hand and said, yes. And she said, an hour of fun is not worth a lifetime of misery. How do you make it last an hour? So anyway, I was in New York and I met some, you can't see me in this picture very well, but I'm right here, that's James Franco and me. And then the king of Kickstarter. I saw him, Zach Braff. But here we are. We're going to have Gorgeous George Show coming right up. I think I hear him. Here he comes! Woo! I can hear it.
Gonna make a move and knocks you over. Your life's the sternest ones gonna put you away. But I'm doing my very best dancing. Every time. Yes, sir. All right, we're going to get to that karaoke song in a second. Woo! Diamonds are forever, baby. And so is Gorgeous George. Ah, beautiful day in the neighborhood. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? What camera are we looking at?
I don't know.
All right.
Welcome back.
Looking at the first one right here.
Welcome back.
Kevin, how you doing, sir?
Good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Right. Now, what's this I hear about the rumor? There was a rumor about something?
There's rumors all over the internet about
us. Is that
about
right?
Us. So, but we're...
Pre-tell.
We look great.
What's this vicious rumor?
All vicious rumors that... one is that we're... have a documentary coming out.
Okay.
That's a good one.
Hark! The angel spoken. We have the documentary. The documentary is out right now. Yes, it is. And we got a lot to talk about and a short time to do it. So tell me some things about what's getting in the news right now. Let's get into some news. Let's talk about some topics real fast.
Well, this is the big news, is that we're going to have Election Day next week. And we're going to
election day.
Erection day.
You mean when you go to the polls, you got to have an erection?
It helps.
Yes.
That's why they give you that little closet.
So you got to be able to pull the level down, right?
It does look
level
like down. A shower curtain. Oh now my God. You think about it.
I'll be damned.
But anyway, so we're going to have. There won't be Eric Cantor. It could be a Democrat, a Jack Tramiel, or it could be a Dave Brack,
okay,
who kind of seated him for the. And they're both professors at Randolph-Macon.
Right.
So we're both guys have never been elected to office before, and
right.
And they will. And one of them will be our next congressman.
I'll be
who's, to be our man in
I'll
Washington.
Be damned. And what else is going on?
Let's see. Well, unfortunately, in the Middle East, in Syria especially, there is a new extremist group, ISIS, that is causing a lot of trouble.
Now, is it Princess ISIS?
It's not, I wish it were.
Okay. I thought it was. Princess
I
ISIS,
wish you know. It were Joanna Cameron.
Yes, yes. That's what I thought it was.
Pretty nice. Pretty nice looking woman.
Yes.
But this is anything but nice looking women.
Mm-hmm.
And they're causing lots of trouble. And unfortunately, we are having to join forces with our hated enemies like Syria and Iran and stuff to...
Right.
To, well,
you
I don't know about
will
Iran,
never but. Be able to give the Middle East and make them a democracy.
Yeah.
You'll never ever make them a democracy. That's it.
Yeah.
No way. No how.
Yeah. And so that's going on.
Yes.
And then of course, Virginia, used to be one of the most conservative states around. We've been blue a few years with the presidential elections, and we have a Democrat governor and two Democrat senators, which are pretty locked in. We now have also gay marriage.
Yes, and I'm gonna say it like I've said it before. It's not about Adam and Steve, it's about Adam and Eve. It has nothing to do with religion, it has nothing to do with it all, even though it has a little bit to do with it, but I'm sorry. If you are gay, all right, if you are homosexual, you have the right to fight for this country. You have the right to do work and do your job, work anywhere you want to work. You have a right to do almost anything. You have a right to be with who you want to be. But a marriage, no. It's a civil union. It's just like saying you want to go to Las Vegas and get married by an Elvis impersonator. That's not a marriage, it's a civil union. Same deal. If you go ahead and get married, you get married to the same person, the same sex, it's not a marriage because it's not being done in a church. It's a civil union. That's all it is. I am not a hater. I don't hate homosexuals. I don't hate gays. Okay? But I don't believe in gay marriage and same-sex marriage. That's it.
Yeah. Yes. Actually, in Las Vegas, even the Elvis in person, I think those, if you sign a marriage license, considered... I think it's considered a real... I think you get married at City Hall, so it doesn't have to be in a church.
One for the money, two for the show. Hey, you got married, and now go down and blow. Anyway.
Well, that would be a San Francisco marriage.
Okay. Well, yeah. And in essence, what they can do, say with me, they can rub dongs together.
With their daddies.
With their daddies. You know it. All right, awesome. Look, it's not difficult. It's not hate. And they want to compare the same thing to black America in the 60s. It's no comparison. It's no comparison to the gays and to what the black Americans went through in the 60s. I'm sorry. There's no comparison. Well, we need privileges. We need rights. There's no comparison.
Yeah. I think that things have changed. I mean, maybe I used to feel the same way you did, but now I feel that the time has come and let them. I mean, it's not going to hurt me any. It's not going
to
change
anything. Kevin, it has nothing to do with hurting anybody. It's just the principle of it.
Yeah.
Look, it has nothing to do with religion. A lot of people that are Christians don't believe in it. But I'm not even mixing religion into it. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about what it is. You know, I'm sorry. I don't, you know, you see two people of the same sex kissing, two people of the same sex making out in a park bench. That's disgusting. It's not normal. You do it, get a room. Go to Holiday Inn and get a freaking room. That's that simple. It has nothing to do with anything else. It's not hate. Have sex in your own domain. Don't do it out in public. We don't want to see it.
Yeah.
And it's the same for a man and a woman too. But I mean, but it's like I said, it's not the same. It's not the same. And if you want the same benefits and the same degree, because you want to get married and have the same, get a living will. Or get a will. And that's what you do. You don't need to be in a marriage. It's not a marriage. It's a freak show. I'm sorry.
Okay.
It's not hate. It's just the truth.
Actually, I have to agree. I do not want to see a man and a woman making love in public either. Two women. Fine.
Yeah, two men.
But wait a minute, two women.
Two men.
Wait a minute, but two women. Wait a minute. Then you go back. Then you get back to two men. Then there's a gay marriage again. And what am I gonna do? And let me tell you something. I see a lot of these things on television. There's all these people getting married now. Gay people getting married. I see almost like 90% women. It just goes to show you that men are men, gay or straight. They don't want to get married.
Well,
it's all the women. They're married.
Personally, no. I mean, you got common law too, and common law is not—it's not here in Virginia. But you live with someone for 5 years, you can call it common law. You live with somebody for five solid years, you can call it common law. That's something. And I get sick of this. I get sick and tired of, hey, we need benefits, we need privileges. Do what you want. Get a living will. Get a will. That's your benefit.
Yeah. Get lawyered up. Actually, I think though, if you begin a relationship with lawyers, you also ended it with lawyers.
Well, anyway, you know, that's the way that works. Now, it's our 20th season.
Yes.
Did someone tell you, did they tell you this, our 20th season?
Yes.
You knew about it, right?
I haven't been here for 20 years, though.
You haven't been here for 20 years?
You have. Who was Gorgeous George?
Who was Gorgeous George
before you? Was there another actor playing?
I don't know.
Playing the part?
It's very hard to tell. Answer looks hazy. But that's to say this degree, Lo, you remember the documentary.
Oh, yeah.
We did the documentary at the University of Richmond for the first part, and then we did the documentary at my humble domain, in the backyard of my humble domain. And we did it, Brandon Hardesty was the one that found the need and found the interest in doing it, and I have mad props for Brandon Hardesty. Brandon Hardesty is on Team GG. That's the way that goes.
And Kenny.
And Kenny.
Yeah.
I don't know. I forget his last name.
Johnson.
But yeah, Kenny. Kenny Johnson. Okay. There you go.
Well, he's actually the real guy from what I gather. Brandon is just the name guy, but Kenny's a very good. You'll know when you
they
see
both him. Have their degree. They both have what they're good at and do what they do. Now,
before we go on, you can see the trailer for this documentary on YouTube. Just go. I think it's called Gorgeous George and his TV show.
That's right.
Just put Gorgeous George TV show in the search on YouTube, and it will turn up, and you'll have a fun time.
Now, upon anything else, we're into silly season. And what I mean by silly season, it's the TV show. And when the TV show comes, the paper hat crowd comes out. The imbeciles come flocking together. And I'm going to break it down like this. I've been doing this show since 1994. August Moon was in this chair. I called August Moon up. I said, do you have in that juice bottle, do you have some gin in there? What are you talking about? I said, hey, I just was asking. Wasn't a prank, I was just asking a question. But anyway, August Moon was in this chair. Then you had other shows, Race and Reality, bunch of people from the KKK, bunch of other people back in the 90s. My show took precedence because my show was different, was unique, beyond any other show on this channel. Then you go back in the days when we had live shows, and then we had 2002 and all the other shows that came about. We have been doing this with love, labor of love. We've been out together, we've been, hell, you know, I could have had a child after this. So when we started the show, I could have a baby. I could have a 20-year-old son or a 20-year-old daughter after doing this show. I don't mince any words. Yes, I've been on public access for 20 years. Well, why don't you do something? Why aren't you in Hollywood? Because guess what? You know what? I'm still working. Haven't got that break yet. This documentary is what's there for us to get that break. That documentary is the tools for us getting this working out and getting this to work. So, you know, hey, there are a lot of people that are talented that never get that break. There are a lot of people that got God gift and talent. They can sing, they can perform, they can act, they are comedians, but they never get that break. Well, guess what? I'm saying we will. I'm saying we will be on mainstream TV in Hollywood. Now,
all right. I can't wait.
These imbeciles, this imbecile in California, this Fagala in California has nothing but better to do than rub his 2-inch dong to everything that I say. And he calls me in my place of work. And
wow.
He calls me in my place of work, an imbecile, okay? He was beating it on the internet. Matt Wilson in England, who converted over to a normal person, came out and said that this fellow named Brennan was beating it on the internet to him, whacking off. And so he didn't even know who he was. And so he denies the whole thing. Now, these trolls come out. Just when the documentary comes out, all these other trolls come out and want to bash me and do whatever. And bash me on the internet and trash me. Talk about my deceased mother. Talk about personal things. My deceased mother and my dog passed away. This is sick. This is obsession. There is a mental illness involved. The old adage is, if you don't like it, don't freaking watch it. But the bottom line is, you're compelled. You want to whack off to me. You want to jerk off. You watched me every time on this channel. You call it a train wreck? Let me tell you something about a train wreck, okay? A train wreck eventually goes by. We've been on here 20 years, so I don't call that a train wreck. I call that continuity. I call that longevity. It's what I call that. And this punk in Wilmington, North Carolina, I don't want to do this because it becomes a tar baby. I become a tar baby by discussing this stuff. And it pisses me off to no end. This SOB has nothing else better to do with his time than fill a bunch of crap about me, calling me housing a predator. Yes, my friend did some jail time. I helped him. Okay?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Yes, I helped him.
Oh, not me.
And then he screwed me. He put a knife in my back.
Oh.
In court.
Yeah.
Okay? That doesn't need to be discussed. But you see, you think that Jerry Sandusky is innocent about his charges. You are a joke, Mr. Harmon. You think that Jerry Sandusky is innocent from all charges. So you want to pass judgment on me and your stupid blog? You're obsessed with me and you're obsessed with Penn State. You're obsessed with Penn State. You're loco. Joe Paterno, great coach, okay? But he did not do anything about Sandusky. Didn't do anything about Sandusky. And you support that? What a hypocrite. And you will pass judgment on me for helping a friend in this trying time? Hey, he's history. So you can't tell me that I'm harboring anybody. You support this. You support child molestation. What
wow.
You do. And you know what? I went through and I was looking through the internet and I saw this right here. This is Chaz Bono. You know Chaz Bono? Chaz Bono is Cher's originally daughter. And Chaz Bono had a sex change. Chaz Bono is now a man. Look at that. And now when we go back to the archives, we look at another picture at Chaz Bono. What a hunk, huh? What a stud, huh? What a hunk. But at the end of the day, this is like long lost brothers, you know? Long lost brothers is what you are. You see that right there? Look at this monstrosity right here. Why don't you shave that disgusting looking beard, you piece of SH? Look at that. Join from the hip. Look at that. Join from the hip. Shave that disgusting beard, you piece of SH. Hey, Leighton, I'm in love with you. Get away from me. You'll give me the cooties. No, Leighton, I changed myself, but I want a hunk of love with you. Hey, get away from me. I'm trying to better myself with my sports casting. I don't know any better. I'm an idiot. Oh, come on. Kiss, 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 kiss. Come over here. Kiss, 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 kiss. That's your brother. That's your long-lost brother separated at birth, you piece of SH. You piece of SH. I am, let me tell you something. You don't like me? Don't watch me. I'm not here, Leighton, to appease you. You're obsessed with me because you have no balls. You are obsessed with me because you have a man crush.
All right.
Why don't you go back to your long-lost brother here? Kiss your long-lost brother and rub dongs together. Rub dongs together. I implore you that. And, now, and I'm going to tell you something here. And you're going to pass judgment on me? Say, well, we get him like to get him mad. Okay. I'm having fun. I'm not getting mad. I'm having fun at what I'm doing. I'm on TV. You're irrelevant. You try to do a sports thing on the internet. Nobody wants to hear your crap. Nobody wants to hear what you've got to say. You're a bubbling idiot. I have been on TV for 20 years. You all are jealous of me. You don't want me to succeed. You don't want me to succeed. You are a jealous individual is what you are. All of you are. You keep talking and talking and talking. The bottom line is, I'm your eye candy. I'm your eye candy. I do as I want. I do as I say. I associate with what I want to associate with. I call who my friends are and who my friends are not. I call the shots. I call the way it is. 20 years of excellence. 20 years of beauty. 20 years of what I am. 20 years of what comedy is about. I choose what I do. I choose the name of the game. I choose who the players are, and I choose what the show is about. You don't like it? Go fly for your fecal. You don't like me? Piss on you. Nobody is telling you to watch me. You don't like it? Kiss my white ass. You piece of scum.
God.
Now, jealousy.
Yes.
Jealousy. I'm excellent. I am fantastic. I'm magnificent. I am what's causing this wonderment in the city of Richmond. So, you know what? Every troll video you put up, I'm going to take down. Every video that you put up, you son of a SOB, you SOB, I'm going to take down and destroy. I am better than you. I am your superior, you fat tub of shit. You fat tub of shit.
Oh, man.
Now.
I think I see him coming in right now.
You all remember Artie Johnson?
Oh, yeah, I love Artie.
Artie Johnson, right?
Yeah.
Take a look at Artie Johnson here. The Gong Show, right? Remember him?
Laughing.
Well, he's looking for his son. Where are you? Where are you, my son? Where are you? Where are you, my son?
All right.
Okay.
Hey, Daddy.
Look at me. I'm from Wisconsin. I'm Wisconsin. I like cheese. Hey, they call me Rotten Chris. I like stir-fried piss in my vodka. I like stir-fried piss and jizz. Yeah, they call me, I'm from Wisconsin. I'm an idiot. Daddy, where are you?
Son, I told you before, I was on the Gong Show. I was playing on the Gong Show. I was on Match Game. I couldn't attend to you. You were too much trouble for me to attend to.
Daddy, that's not the way to treat your son. You're not the way to treat your son. I want you to give me some breast milk. I want to nibble your cock. I want to play with your ding-a-ling and your cock. Well, son, I'm going to disown you because you're talking out of your hat. No, I'm dysfunctional. Well, you are dysfunctional and you can be with your mother. I'm leaving you. I'm going back to Las Vegas. Get away from me.
Daddy, I made some stir-fried vodka for you and some piss and fettuccine. Come and get it. Yeah. Come and get it, Daddy. Come and get it.
Leave me alone.
Come and get it. I gotta go, son.
Listen. Listen to me. Woo! You know what's causing that? It ain't Ric Flair. It's Gorgeous George. Ric Flair is my idol, but I do the woos. Woo! All day and all night. I am. Now, you know what? People's calling want to say that I'm fat. I lost 40 freaking pounds, buddy.
40 pounds. Okay, I am. Look at me. I am what's causing all this. I am what every girl wants. And I am every girl's fantasy right here, baby. And if you don't like it, hey, kiss my white ass. Woo! This is what it boils down to. And I lost my microphone. Anyway, Vince.
Look who's here.
Vince is in the house.
Yeah, hello.
Oh. You're dropping your mic also,
I am
too.
I'm dropping my mic. It's so funny.
You are missing out on some good entertainment here.
I noticed when I walked in here, it was like somebody's ripping on somebody, and it's like, here I am.
You know what?
And drop my mic again.
And before you even go there, I'm going to go there for you.
What's that?
Okay, you did beat us, but that was your Super Bowl.
Of course.
That was your Super Bowl.
Yeah, that was our Super Bowl.
At the end of the day, we'll be in the playoffs, and you won't.
Who cares? We beat you.
Yeah, you'll be in the playoffs. We'll be in the playoffs.
That's okay.
That's all I got to say about that. So I'm going to cut it to the quick right there.
It's just like 1989. We all won in 15. Yeah. You beat us. So what?
Yeah.
But then again, that was your Super Bowl.
You see that? With the bangs in the hair? Artie is your father. With all the bangs in your hair, Artie is your father. Let me tell you something here. I'm going to tell you the way it is. I wake up. I don't care what some other man thinks about me. I call the shots. I pull the strings. I call the shots. I don't care what some deformed mongoloid or what some runt thinks about me. Okay, I've been doing this. Where the hell are you? Are you on TV? Are you doing something with your life? Huh? What are you doing with your life? I don't think you're doing a damn thing with your life. You're in your mom's basement in your computer. Stroking your butt. Stroking off with a violin to me.
Wait a minute. I thought when you showed Artie Johnson there that I was on Match Game tonight.
Were you on Match Game?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, I found that picture. All this thing with Artie Johnson and that punk, I find it very interesting.
That's right. Very interesting. Listen, I hate to be a tar baby.
Wow.
I hate to dig it up and be a tar baby and go in every degree. But you know what? You smell the aroma. Am I arrogant? Oh, yes, I am. Am I cocky? You damn believe. Is my character who I am? Part of it is, buddy. Am I a cartoon? No, I'm a human being just like you and everybody else is. Am I who I am on TV? That's part of me. It's part of my persona. But you know what? I don't need an answer to you. I don't need an answer to some fat SOB. I don't need an answer to that. Lose some weight, okay? I did. Okay, get a facelift because only your mother could love it, and maybe she could put your mouth on her nipples and maybe get some breast milk, because you are an idiot, Mr. Harmon. You want to trash me, Mr. Harmon? You are a bona fide piece of S.
Wait, you're an idiot. Did you say Mr. Harmon?
Harmon.
Oh, I thought you said Herman.
Harmon.
Pee Wee Herman.
Yes. You know, 20 years. 20 years. 20 years.
20 years.
And I'm still on public access TV, yes. But guess what? It's in the works. It's in the works.
Wow. Yeah. You've been on longer than American Idol.
Yeah.
You know?
And you
that's
probably,
what it is.
And you probably sing them a lot better than some of the contestants.
Hey, let's go ahead with that. Let's do that with that Johnny Cash song right now.
You're only...
All right.
Let's do it. Can you do it? Can we do it?
Yeah, Johnny Cash.
Yeah.
All right.
Can we do it?
Yeah.
Well, I need a microphone.
Hey, Burns, Burns, Burns. The yeast infection. Yeast infection. You going to figure out something? Well, I mean, if it's back in the back, we can do it next week. It's not big. We're doing now? Vince, how goes it, man?
Everything goes fine, and then I walked in, and then I see this stuff here, and it's like, uh-oh.
Yes.
Something's burning here.
Something's burning. Burns, burns, burns. Like a yeast infection. Like a yeast infection. Hey, let's do it, man. Let's do it.
All right.
We got to close one camera in this to do this here.
We'll figure it out.
I came in, and I was trying to listen to a little bit of the World Series.
All right. Hey, who's up?
It's right now tied 2-2.
Okay, Kansas City Royals. Kansas City Royals will win the World Series against the SF Giants. All right, let's. Whoa, buddy, what are we doing? You're going way too close.
Okay.
We got to do it.
We want to sing.
All right, here he goes. This is. I know you're going to do it, right?
We'll do it.
Right? Okay.
We got it. Wait a minute. That's just the.
Let's bring it to surface. Bring it to surface right here. Got it here.
I need a. Is this microphone working here?
Yeah, you can do it.
Okay, now can you uh, And you read. You just keep talking.
Yeah, I just.
You'll know when it's time.
You'll know when I know when it's time.
Yeah, you'll know when it's time.
I'll know when the birth is ready.
Yeah, he always knows when it's time.
All right. You know when the birth is ready.
All right.
We know when the birth is ready.
And now we have.
Now, I don't want you to arc yourself or hurt yourself there. You're going to hurt yourself?
It's going to be good. It's going to be good. All right, we're all set?
Woo, woo.
Okay, you're going to, we have the lines right
Let's
here.
Do it. Let's do it. Yeah. Sure brought my cowboy hat. Love is a burning thing, and it makes my testicles burn. Dun, 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 dun. Bound by the wild desire when I fell in love with Mrs. Jones.
Whoa!
I fell in love with Mrs. Jones, and it burns, 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 and she went down on me, and the flames went higher, and it burns like a yeast infection, like a yeast infection.
Dancing now.
No, I should be, shouldn't I?
There we go.
I fell into a burning ring of fire, and I went down on her, and the flames got higher, and it burns, burns, burns like a yeast infection, like a yeast infection. And it burns, 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 and the taste of love is so sweet. When hearts like ours meet, I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire, and my balls burned daily, and the flames went higher, and it burns, burns, burns like a yeast infection. Like a yeast infection. And the fire burns. And it burns like the rings the round in my toilet. And I went down, down, down. And the flames went higher. And it burns, burns, burns. Like when my urine burns. And it burns, burns, burns. Like red blood coming out of my urine. And the ring of fire. And the ring of fire. I want to see you undress. And put some fire. Let's make some fire. Woo!
Woo!
That's my version of it.
There you go.
You like that?
Very good.
And I'm sorry. Hey, I don't mean to offend anybody. That, you know, this is not church. You know, we're going to.
Are you sure?
Let's open our hymn books today and let's read.
Yes, please.
Let's open our hymn books. Let's read George 3:69.
You know.
Yeah, I came to this world with you. I came naked, and now I need you to clothe me. Yes. Producer. Okay. And this station is not responsible for the things that come out of my mouth.